What is good, everybody, and welcome back to the channel. Today, we're taking a look at 10 back-to-school style essentials. Now, what this means are different parts of an outfit that are essential for you for back-to-school that can be very versatile throughout different outfits. So just things in general that are relatively cheap. All of these are under 50 bucks, besides the shoes, but all the things you can all come together to make really dope outfits and can be kind of versatile through all of it. Now, I said there's gonna be some of my last back to school videos, you know, a few weeks ago, whatever, but a lot of you guys keep telling me that back to school doesn't start for you for a few more weeks. So I thought, if you guys are liking the videos, school still hasn't started for you guys, you're still in summer, let's go ahead and show you some cool things to get for under 50 bucks. It's kind of relatively cheap because a lot of you guys, the price points, you like to see a little bit of that cheaper end. So without further ado, let's go ahead and check out some of this really dope stuff we got for back to school. Of course, as you guys know, it's time for a nice coffee, as always. This is a nice iced cold brew right here, or just a cold brew in general. And I'm using, actually, Peter McKinnon's cup. I went and bought it from the Jamestown company that, you know, he is in affiliation with, and that's what we're drinking today. Let's just jump right off the bat and start with these shoulder bags, because there's two of them in this video, and apparently, different places like Urban Outfitters are finding out that this is a trend, which has been a trend for a while now. Now, I think a lot of people wear Supreme shoulder bags. That's just like, literally when I go to the mall all the time, I see people who don't even look like they're into Supreme and stuff wearing shoulder bags, a Supreme shoulder bag. And a lot of different companies are now coming out with them. This one is one that really stood out to me from Kappa, but mainly from Urban Outfitters, actually. It's a little bit smaller. Now, it's kind of a weird size, but I really like the strap. You guys know I have a few different Kappa pieces. I just really like the stripe because it kind of stripe or strap, because it kind of sticks out. And it's just not your typical strap, not just a standard color like the other one that I have. And it's just a nice little patch here. It says Kappa embroidered, but it's very small. You can't really fit too much in here. You could probably fit a phone, your keys, your wallet, whatever. But I think this color in particular is one that you can wear with so many different shirts or anything like that, because they had a different color red there, and this one is just perfect. It look at that. It just sits there right on your shoulder. You can throw it around like this if you want to, if you don't want to show in. And it's just a nice little bag. I'm sure you're allowed to have something like this at school. I have, essentially, I guess you could say it's like a purse. A lot of people make fun of me for wearing these things, but they're convenient. I'm wearing sweatpants right now, or sweat shorts, and having things kind of flopping around, not the vibe. Having them in here, absolutely perfect. And you don't have to worry about getting pickpocketed. I don't know why I'd get pickpocketed at school. Some kids out there are jerks. And then the other shoulder bag is this Champion one right here. Of course, I would expect Champion to come out with something, because Champion is a huge brand. And this, again, was at Urban Outfitters as well. The last bag came in at $45, and this bag came in at 40 bucks. So Champion right here, pretty cool as well. Different shape, a little bit longer. This reminds me of the Supreme Louis Vuitton shoulder waist bag, whatever they got going on there. That was actually the fanny pack, I believe. Kind of more laid out flat like this. Gucci has one as well. Camo's a cool color, very essential, as you can see. I think this looks really cool. It's pretty neutral colored, and you can fit as well more things in here. Probably you can fit your pencils wherever you need to if you don't want to take a backpack, but I don't, what about your papers? I'm not sure. So those are just kind of the few first things. The first two I had to get, and this is kind of what based me doing this video, because I saw these at the store and I thought, dang, they're coming out with so many good things, and I gotta keep sharing this stuff with you guys, because more and more shoulder bags, more and more essentials are coming out. And this one right here, this is one of my favorites. It's actually, the other one was my favorite before, but when I put this on, it actually, the colors look really dope. So I had some shots. I showed Alex wearing that one as well. And without further ado, we'll continue on to the essentials, which I have to just straight talk and jump to one that you guys ask me about like every day. For the longest time, I was looking for a pair of pants that I could wear with anything. Like just pants in general. I wanted them to be black so I could wear them with a lot of different colors, because with blue sometimes it's hard for me to mix those colors up. And a pair of crop pants in particular. I've been wearing a lot of skinny jeans and stuff in the past. I've been wearing these. They're a slop. They're a crop slim skinny chino, I guess you could say, from ASOS. 22 bucks. And I kind of haven't really told you guys about it. I've been wearing it in so many pictures. And you can see in the picture in the thumbnail I'm wearing them, or both pictures in the thumbnail. And it's these pants. Again, ASOS right here. $22. And I think, are these inside out right now? No, they're not. So simple. It's a very lightweight material, and they're just a crop pant. I went with a size 31-32, and there's not much to say about these. They're a crop pant. They're black. I like how they're a little bit skinnier, not too wide. Like the Dickies that I have are a little bit wide, and these just, literally, I can wear these with anything. I throw these on with a pair of Air Force Ones, I'm gonna show you guys. Looks good. Throw these on with a pair of high top Vans, high top Jordan Ones, whatever. I think it looks good, and they're just perfect. And for so long, I had a pair of navy pants, and I was just like, I need a pair of pants that literally will just be so easy to throw on with any outfit. I don't have to worry about it. And that's what these are. Black shirt, boom. White shirt, boom. Striped shirt, boom. Tie-dye shirt, boom. Literally everything I wear this with. So These pants are my go-to. They're not expensive. I'm gonna have to order another pair because I'm wearing the heck out of those. $22. Come on, that's so cheap for a pair of pants. A pair of jeans are typically, at the cheapest end, $35, $30 from like H&M. The quality on those is nice. I wear them out to nice dinners. No one can tell. I wear them out to just go to the mall. Same thing. A lot of you guys just asked me about the pants, and I've been kind of telling you guys, but I haven't formally told you, so there they are. Let me move a little bit closer here. I'm sitting on my desk. Moving along with kind of the essentials would have to be something as far as a belt. For a while, I didn't really wear belts much. I wore pants and they would just kind of sag down. And then at some point it got annoying because I'd be walking and Sophie, my girlfriend, would have to grab my belt loops and pull my pants up. What if I'm like holding something, like it's bad. So I went ahead and initially I've been wearing this ASOS weekday belt that actually Magnus Ronin got me in a challenge that I let him, you know, kind of pick my outfit. Very nice silver buckle that matches all the jewelry that I wear. And I think it's kind of a nice subtle belt, not too stiff, and just offers a pretty decent look. It's not like too in your face. I don't really like to wear like Gucci belts or anything like that because one, my shirts cover it. Why would I spend $400 on a belt that like it's only I know that I'm wearing it? I don't really care. And so I found another belt because that one was sold out for a while and is actually from Top Man. It was $15 and is essentially the same thing, just a little bit darker of a silver. This is definitely gonna be a little bit worse quality. It's very stiff and I guess I haven't broken it in fully yet. And the buckle on the top isn't like hollow. It's a cheap belt. It's $15. I thought I'd show you guys just a nice cheap belt just to, you know, give you guys an example of something you could work with if that belt is sold out. Now the ASOS one, I will definitely put link down below if they have it anymore. But again, I think it was just like a limited release or something. But very good pick by Magnus. And I wasn't wearing a belt before. And I told myself, so long, I'm gonna go get a belt. Let me go get a belt. Well, you know, he got me one. So I need to keep it moving and go towards these shirts because I've been wearing a lot of t-shirts lately. And I wanna kind of mix in t-shirts and long sleeves because in the next maybe few months, you might see long sleeves come out because the weather's gonna get a little bit cooler. Here in Georgia, it's cool during the mornings and then it just gets really humid at the end of the day. So sometimes I can wear long sleeves, but mainly t-shirts. One of the big ones right here is from Urban Outfitters, just a tie-dye t-shirt. And you guys can do this at home, and I don't know if I'm gonna make a video on like how to do it because there's so many videos on how to tie-dye t-shirts. This one is $34. Now, I know that's a lot for a tie-dye t-shirt, and that's why I feel like you guys could probably just do it at home. You can get a t-shirt for $5 from Uniqlo and just do a tie-dye yourself, and the total cost would be $8. You could probably find some more tie-dye stuff as well on different eBays. Amazon actually has a Grateful Dead inspired shirt that I ended up buying, and I really like that as well. And that was only $22. So Urban Outfitters, they're taxing because this is their own line of shirts and it's tie-dye. So I don't know what's up with them charging $34 on these. I do think it is a good looking shirt and the fit is good. Now that's a big thing. A lot of the shirts at Urban Outfitters, they are like a shorter sleeve. I like a little bit longer of a sleeve where it's kind of boxy, not like necessarily too boxy and the sleeve is flipped up, but it's a little bit boxier, not like back in the day Fear of God boxy, but just kind of a little bit more boxy where the shoulders come down. I like the sleeves to be a little bit longer. So again, this one was $34. It's the $22 version on Amazon that I got, and I took a fire picture on my Instagram with. And tie-dye, I've seen just more and more people kind of messing with the tie-dye. Just designers coming out with different, you know, tie-dye things or wearing tie-dye vintage shirts. And I've been doing some hunting for some vintage shirts as well, which is leading me to my next thing. I just think at the time of the year right now, it's really cool, and I'm just vibing wearing it. You know, spontaneous colors. I say that as I'm wearing all black. So like I said, I've been going kind of with the vintage route and searching through some vintage stores. Now my girlfriend goes to school a few hours away from me in that area. There tends to be a little bit better thrifting out there. Where I live, a lot of people know about thrifting and anything good is gonna get scooped up immediately. The first thing that I got was a shirt here, is a Chelsea Football Club Adidas t-shirt. I don't know when this came out. I don't know how old this is. Actually, I think it was from 2011 as the tag might say down there. And it's just a nice Chelsea Football Club shirt. Now, I'm not in particular with any football club. And when I say football, I mean soccer for people in America. And this shirt, just the colors would that look cool. It is kind of nicely washed. It's kind of just, you know, been washed a lot of times. And then it has a nice neck lining. That's the one thing that I look for. I like to have a thicker neck lining. And it is a little bit boxier as well. This was $1.40. Like, come on, Adidas shirt for $1.40, I think that's a pretty good steal. Now, the problem is this one came out to be a little bit small for me. So my roommate Alex wore it in a few clips. You guys might have seen that. Pretty cool shirt though for $1.50. Found it at Goodwill, and I have some pretty decent luck when I'm finding stuff at Goodwill. And I found another shirt here, which is a size large. Again, boxy, nice necklining. And I just saw this cool little design on the front. I thought it looked pretty dope. And I thought this could be cool, maybe throw on just like a black t-shirt like this. And this one was $2. Again, if you just kind of go into Goodwill and have that mindset of like, you know, anything that I see that just instantly catches my eye, let me grab that because it's only gonna be about $2-$3. And for me, sometimes I look at it and I'll maybe look at this and be like, eh, maybe that's kind of corny. But then I'm like, you know, I thought it looked cool initially when I saw it. And if it fits good, why not? Like, it's just a cool vintage t-shirt. And then later on, as I kind of looked at it, I saw it's from Cancun, Mexico. You can see kind of like right here, there's a little bit of a logo. You can't really see it, but this is from Cancun. It's just like a touristy t-shirt, but I wouldn't have known that if I seen, you know, this logo. And that's why it caught my eye. And I thought $2, Cancun, whatever. It's dope. Why not just go ahead, grab it for $2 and have a cool t-shirt. So I'm trying to, you know, vamp that up. I bought like 3 more shirts on eBay as well this week, but I'm definitely... Okay guys, so I actually got 2 packages in with 3 shirts that are vintage that I got from eBay that I was just talking about. So I thought, let's open them real quick. Really quickly, first one up, ooh, Bob Marley tee with the nice tie-dye on the sleeve. This is from 1998. Status Q high-end systems. Gucci just came out with a Paramount t-shirt and I was like, you know what? I'm not paying $590 for one. I'm gonna go get a vintage one off of eBay. So this one's really dope. Can't find the exact year on it, but 3 more vintages. Without further ado, let's get back into it. Hunting in my Goodwills. Then I wanted to show a little bit of an essential as far as socks go. Now, a lot of the socks that I wear are these. These are actually from Finish Line and it was like $5 for 2 sets of them. And they're really beaten, worn. And a lot of the other ones, I just bought some more that are just kind of white and black socks that were like $12. These are from Urban Outfitters. They were $8. They're a cool camo, kind of goes with, you know, a little bit of a nice vibe. I think with those black pants, these and like a white t-shirt, it's a pretty cool, you know, mixture right there. But again, this is just kind of like that desert camo, not desert, I don't know, pop camo, whatever they call it. $8 for one pair is a bit steep, but Urban Outfitters, I thought it'd be cool to include a pair of socks, a little bit different, not just your typical, and I'll link down below some of the socks from Finish Line as well if I can find. I need to move around. I feel like I'm stagnant. Here's a little tag from the socks as well if you guys want to check that out. $8, and I went, these are like a size 10 to 13, I'm typically an 11. I get a lot of questions about my jewelry. So a lot of you guys ask about the bracelets, not necessarily the watch. I've done a video on my watch. This is a Rolex Air King. Very nice watch, and I'm very fortunate to have it. I've worn a few different watches over the years, Michael Kors, yada, yada, yada. I've always had the mindset of wanting a Rolex because it's just such a nice brand, very good quality. And I know there's a lot of better brands out there, but as far as what am I able to afford and the quality, this and Omega were really good options, but ended up going with the Rolex. Now, I don't think everybody should have a Rolex, but I was able to buy it and I saved it for a while to get it kind of as a gift to myself. But other than that, let me take that off. You can see the bracelets that I wear normally would be these two. In general, this bracelet I just got recently is from Jacob Wallace and Fernando. They actually sent it out to me. They did a little bit of a drop. It is a dope star bracelet. It's just cool. It has these little, you know, stars on it, and it's big, sometimes flip over. And then these, I get a ton of questions about this bracelet right here. This is actually a hair tie. This is my girlfriend's hair tie from Free People, if you guys know what that is. I went there to see if they had more, and actually they're sold out. Okay guys, so last minute update. I did end up finding those hair ties, and you can get them on Amazon, 100 of them for like $9. So here you go right here. They're literally all the same. This is all different colors. I should have gotten like all just like neutral colors, but here they are on my wrist. Same thing, black, gray, whatever. Perfect, they stretch out a little bit, and I like to wear them like a watch or something. So thought I'd give you that. I'm gonna link those down below. But I just like the little things that aren't meant to necessarily be bracelets all the time, just be a cool little subtle thing, and I wear it with my watch. It's to be like you're wearing like a hair tie with a watch. That's what I like, and if I like it, that's all that matters. But I did end up finding some cool ones at Topman as well, and they're just these cool bracelets right here. They're just a little bit big for me. Neutral colors at a bunch of different colors. You can see a little bit big for me, but I thought some of you guys might like these because they're neutral. This is like a knit one. I don't really like this one as much. Weird to wear. And you just kind of throw these on and kind of mix them up, and it will look cool with a watch. Now, I typically wear my watch on my left hand, but for this, I'll put it on the other hand, and you guys can see that feels really weird to put on like that. See, it's just, they're just a little bit big for me, but if these fit a little bit nicer and if I could find a little bit better of fitting ones, I definitely would like those as well. So Topman, pretty cool, $20 for 5 bracelets. We've been going for a while now. So I got 2 things left that I wanted to show you guys. One of them was a shirt that I showed a long time ago, but not a lot of people saw the video because it was kind of a mixture and a kind of a weird pickup video. Is this Stussy Stussy shirt. A lot of different ways of pronouncing it. People correct me a lot of the time, and I'm sorry if I said it wrong. This striped shirt you guys love and you always mention it to me. It's got the Stussy around the neck, or Stussy. This is $50 at the top of the price, but they sell to Urban Outfitters and they still sell them. I bought it a few months ago, actually. The stripe is so clean. It's perfect for just those black pants. You can wear with black shoes. And I just love throwing this in together with a bunch of different outfits. So just another shirt I wanted to show you. Black and white, perfect. You can wear it with so many different variations and essential, I think, for school. I can't forget the shoes that I was talking about. These are the Air Force One Swoosh Pack. Now these, when I first put the video out on shoes for back to school, these were like a huge hit. And a lot of them had some different steals on Grailed and eBay. You guys ate all that up, and I can't really find too many good deals now for under $100. You could probably find them around like $120, $130. This pair here, I've worn the life out of them, but they have these removable swooshes. You can change the colors. I think that's just perfect. Have a shoe that is versatile in any outfit that you have. You can have a colored swoosh, you can have a black swoosh, you can have a white swoosh, yellow, green, whatever. You can have a different color swoosh and change it for the time of the day. And these are a nice off-white, and it's not just like a crystal white or like a super bright white that if you get one thing messy with it, it'll look bad. These look good, a little bit scuffed up. So I like these. I actually got these in a mystery box. If you guys didn't see that, the $5,000 mystery box, and they're called the swoosh pack. I think it's the sale swoosh pack. And then finally, I missed out on that last item, would be this Wilson jacket from Forever 21. A nice little windbreaker. It's not too hot to have a jacket yet, but this is a nice thin windbreaker. Wilson, always known as being the tennis brand. I played tennis a little bit in middle school, and I always known Wilson for tennis brand, tennis balls, just Supreme tennis balls, whatever. I actually raffled those off, and I saw this and I thought it was just a cool little piece. The materials aren't that great, but it's $35 from Forever 21. And if you guys know Forever 21, you know the quality is not the best, but they offer some good styles for a relatively cheap price. So pretty cool windbreaker right here. Colors are nice. It reminded me of kind of like the Tommy Hilfiger era of vintage jackets and things like that. So for $35, I thought it was cool. It's pretty light. I think it's pretty versatile as well. So that is gonna wrap it up for this back to school style essentials video. Again, I'll link those other creators down below who you guys have seen who have amazing videos as well on amazing sense of style. I'll see you guys next time. This is Harrison signing out.